Longtime NHL goaltender Roberto Luongo has announced his retirement from the NHL. We're going to take a quick look at his career and what the recapture penalties are going to look like on the salary cap implications for the Canucks and the Florida Panthers. We'll get into all that coming up next. Welcome back here to Top Shelf Hockey. Now, of course, we have more breaking news out of the Florida Panther organization. Longtime goaltender in the NHL, Roberto Luongo, has announced his retirement. Now, there has been some speculation leading up here in the last week or two that we would have some clarity on Luongo's future. And many suspected if he was not going to be able to play this year, that he would more than likely end up in LTIR that most players do. That's usually what happens rather than actually retire. Now, of course, Luongo had one of those wonky contracts that are no longer legal in the NHL. Way back before they changed the rules, he had one of those super long-term NHL contracts, and there was rules put in place that if any of these players like Luongo that had those deals were to retire before the contracts were up, there would be recapture penalties going against the team that issued the contract, which in this case was the Vancouver Canucks. Due to Luongo retiring, the Canucks now face a cap recapture penalty here of just a little bit over $3 million for the next 3 years. Now, of course, when they traded him from Vancouver down to the Florida Panthers, they did retain a little bit of that salary, which I believe was around $800,000 that they were already paying. So obviously, it's not a full addition of $3 million. Their cap hit's going to increase by around 2.2 to 2.3 million, something like that, with this new recapture penalty on here. So, of course, this is big news that impacts the Canucks way more than it impacts the Florida Panthers here. Now, TSN senior writer Frank Saravalli has indicated on Twitter here, and I'll put that up on the screen, his understanding of the situation is the Florida Panthers actually encouraged Luongo to retire instead of going on LTIR. They not only saved the $3.6 million in real cash salary, but the $1.1 million recapture penalty is negligible compared to wrangling with $5.7 million on LTIR. Now, of course, when contracts go on LTIR, they're certainly able to increase and surpass the cap amount by that amount that they get the relief from. But at the same time, it does complicate things as well in other situations with the salary cap. And teams would really prefer not to use it if at all possible. So, of course, this small recapture penalty for 3 years is much, much easier for the Florida Panthers to deal with here. So it does sound like they might have encouraged him, but ultimately it was his decision here. And let's take a quick look here at the letter that Roberto Luongo released here to NHL fans explaining his decision. Now, if you want to see the full article here, I'll link it down below in the description. I'm just going to read you a quick excerpt here. It says, "There's a lot I want to say. This is one of the toughest decisions I've faced in my life, and it took me a long time to make it. After thinking about it over and over in the past 2 months and listening to my body, I made up my mind. It just feels like the right time for me to step away from the game. I love the game so much, but the commitment I require to prepare to keep my body ready has become overwhelming. Since I had my hip surgery a couple years ago, I've been showing up 2 hours before practice and 3 hours before every game to work out my hip. Even at night, whether it was the night before a game or even a night off, there I was rolling it out, doing strengthening exercises. My entire life revolved around recovery, strengthening, and making sure I was ready to go the next day. I was willing to make that sacrifice because I love the game. I love being part of it, love being in the action and competing with my teammates. I was willing to go through it all for my love of hockey. After the season ended and I had an opportunity to step away, I started thinking about things. Looking back at the season, I just wasn't happy with my performance. I played better in the second half, but it wasn't up to the standards I expect of myself on a nightly basis. I wanted to be the backstop, to give my team a chance to win every night. I wanted to be on top of my game, stealing wins. It just wasn't there, at least not as much as I wanted it to be." Now, of course, he does go on to thank a whole bunch of people throughout his career that have had his impact and how the family impact of the decision here as well. If you want to read the full letter here, I'll link it down in the description. But ultimately, Roberto Luongo is going out because he can't feel like he can compete at a high enough level to be able to provide what he feels his team needs from him on a nightly basis. Certainly an admirable thing and a no easy decision. We do see many players try to play out their contracts, even though you can tell their bodies are broken down and they just can't get up to the performance like they used to do here in the past. Now, of course, Roberto Luongo is one of the greatest goalies here of all time, in my opinion. Let's take a quick look at some of his career statistics. They're very impressive. Of course, he's played parts of 19 seasons between his time with the Florida Panthers and Vancouver Canucks. Of course, originally drafted by the New York Islanders. He's played in over 1,000 NHL games for a goaltender. It's especially impressive. It's impressive for any position, but especially in net. So certainly, Bobby Lewis had an incredible career. Part of Team Canada, the Olympics was probably one of his bigger moments in his career as well, and certainly will go down as not only being one of the greatest goalies from Canada in international competition, but just strictly in the NHL as a whole. There's certainly a debate, though, whether or not he's a Hall of Famer. He's had an incredible career, but of course, as we know, being really good doesn't always get you in. There's all kinds of players who appear to have Hall of Fame-type careers that are still waiting to get in here after being eligible for a number of years that we just seen here with the recent announcement of this year's class that's being inducted. So obviously, Roberto Luongo had one heck of a career. He's going out because he can't feel he can keep up with the demands that his body has to go through anymore. This has major implications for the Vancouver Canucks and their salary cap. Obviously, this could impact them going after a free agent like we've been hearing. It's been reported Jim Benning's very, very interested in signing Tyler Myers, and he's going to be looking for a $6 to $7 million deal. They're still going to sign Brock Besser as well and a few others. So this certainly might complicate things, and this extra few million dollars that the Canucks are going to have counted against their salary cap is certainly going to impact future decisions here. So of course, as always, want to hear your thoughts and opinions in the comment section. What do you think of Roberto Luongo's decision? Where do you think he ranks all time amongst goaltenders? Do you think he's possibly a Hall of Famer? And how do the Canucks react to this recapture penalty? Could it change their potential offseason plans here? Of course, if you're new to the channel, I hope you consider subscribing. There's plenty more content coming. This is an incredibly busy news cycle here for NHL hockey right now. All kinds of free agent and trades and stuff going on. So stay tuned. I'll keep you all up to date with all the breaking news. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.